So today we are going to see again two chapters from industrial pharmacy. We have already seen three formulation: tablet, capsule, aerosols. We have also seen then suppository. We have also completed. So what is remaining? Suspension, emulsion. Today we will see that. Then after that, semi solids and monophasic liquid dosage form. Okay, in that there are only few points in case of liquid dosage form. Particularly solutions, syrup, elixir, etc. We are going to just take a definitions and all that. After that, parenteral products are the main chapter again. Okay, cosmetic in a short, parenteral product, semi solids in short, that will end your sutics also. So today we will try to finish these two topics, suspension and emulsion. So if you want to understand this suspension emulsion in better way, so actually these two chapters are basically, they are dependent on two chapters from physical pharmacy. Suspension is totally depends on the colloid chapter from physical pharmacy, and this emulsion depends totally on the surface tension and interfacial phenomena. That's why I was messaged in the morning to watch those previous videos whatever we have completed in the physical pharmacy, because these two topics are based upon that only. And DLVO theory and all that. So I'm not going to repeat the DLVO theory, and because I have already covered that portion in the physical pharmacy. Only formulation aspects, then additives, stability problems, etc. So those points on which they used to ask frequently the question, that will be covered. Suspension and emulsion. So basically they are nothing but the liquid dosage form. So as we have seen the solid dosage form, in that we have seen tablet, capsule. Then your suppositories. Okay, so likewise that there is a liquid dosage form. Okay, so in which active ingredient is either dissolved in the particular vehicle, or dissolved or suspended or dispersed as a oil globules. Okay, so if that active ingredient is dissolved in the vehicle, that is known as a syrup. Okay, syrups, elixir, or all that is known as a monophasic dosage form. मोनोफेजिक लिक्विड डोसेज फॉर्म, ठीक है. आपका ड्रग अगर सिंपली डिसॉल्व किया है सिरप में या फिर कोई दूसरा कोई एरोमेटिक व्हीकल में, सो दैट इज नोन एज अ सिंपल लिक्विड्स एंड दे विल हैव ओनली वन फेज. ओके, सो बिकॉज एपीआई विल बी सोल्यूबल इन द व्हीकल, दैट्स व्हाई दैट इज अ मोनोफेजिक. सो सिंगल कंपोनेंट और सिंगल फेज सिस्टम. बट इफ योर ड्रग इज इनसोल्युबल इन द व्हीकल, सो इन दैट केस You have to suspend that drug. You have to formulate the suspension. So that is a biphasic dosage form. Again, in case of emulsion, so you have to particularly oil soluble drugs and oils for various purposes, like for internal use, for external use, etc. Suspension are also for internal use, external use. Okay, suspension in that solid particles are suspended in the viscous medium or viscous vehicle, so that is a suspension. So and there should not be settlement. And emulsion means what? Particularly oil soluble drug or oily droplets, they are dispersed in the aqueous phase. Okay, so that's why here two phase system exists, both in a suspension as well as emulsion. There are two phase system. Okay, so what is it? Biphasic liquid dosage form. Both suspension and emulsion, they are nothing but the biphasic liquid dosage form. So in which solid particles are dispersed or suspended into dispersion medium. Now if solid, so basically in the suspension, solid particles are suspended in the dispersion medium. Okay, and in case of emulsion, so oily drugs, they are dispersed as a fine droplets in the another phase. Okay, in case of emulsion, you have two different phases. Oily phase will be there, and your aqueous phase will be there. So one phase will be dispersed into another phase in case of emulsion. But in case of suspension, so finely divided or poorly soluble drug, finely divided drug and poorly soluble drug, particles of that solute particle of drug, that will be suspended into a dispersion medium. That is a suspension. Both these system, suspension and emulsion, they are thermodynamically unstable. Ye stable nahi hota hai. These are the two system which are known as the thermodynamically unstable. Remember, they are the system which are thermodynamically unstable. So you have to enhance their stability by using addition of either suspending agent in case of suspension, then in case of immersion you have to add the emulsify agent, etc. So suspensions, these are the dosage form consisting two pages. First will be the continuous phase, or it is known as the external phase. So vehicle or the medium in which solid particles are suspended, that is known as a continuous phase or external phase. Okay, and which is normally a liquid in nature. Most of the time it is a liquid in nature or semi-solid. Dispersed solid particles, they are known as the internal phase. Okay. So suspensions, if they are made up of two phase system, first one is your drug and drug particles. आपका जो ड्रग है, इनसोल्युबल ड्रग जो है या फिर पुअरली सोल्युबल या पुअरली वेटेड ड्रग जो है, उसके सॉलिड सॉलिड मतलब पाउडर विल बी सस्पेंडेड इन द व्हीकल. अभी जो व्हीकल है, व्हीकल मतलब मीडियम, वाटर पॉटेंशन भी हो सकता है या फिर ऑयल, दूसरा सिरप, दूसरा कुछ भी व्हीकल हो सकता है. ठीक है, सो दैट व्हीकल इज नोन एज अ एक्सटर्नल फेज. ओके, दैट इज नोन एज अ कंटिन्यूअस फेज और एक्सटर्नल फेज. एंड वॉट एवर the solid particles are there which is dispersed in the continuous phase or external phase. So solid particles, they are known as a dispersed phase or internal phase. And the internal phase is made up of your particles that are insoluble, but they can be dispersed throughout the continuous phase. So it is a biphasic system. Suppose aapka drug agar soluble hai aapke solvent mein, aapka medium mein, jaise glycerin ho gaya. So in that case, there is no need to formulate suspension and anything. So you just formulate the solution, okay? Solution, oral solution or syrup. So agar aapka drug jo hai, agar wo soluble nahi hai, that is poorly soluble or it is a poorly wettable, then only you have to go for suspension, okay? There are lot of medicinal agent which are not soluble. They lack the solubility. That's why you have to formulate them in a suspension. We'll see it. So biphasic liquid dosage form in which solid particles are dispersed or suspended into a dispersion medium. Now the dispersion medium is known as a continuous phase or external phase. And whatever particles are being dispersed, they are known as a dispersed phase or internal phase. Okay. And internal phase is mostly made up of your solid particle. External phase, it is a liquid in nature. Remember, size of dispersed phase is the most for the most of the pharmaceutical suspension. It is in a range of 1 to 50 micron. So most of the suspension ka range kya hota hai? Particles ka 1 to 50 micron. Question aa sakta hai iske upar. So in the size of dispersed phase, that is solid particle, in the most of the pharmaceutical suspension, it is between 1 to whatever we are going to see. So the particle size of that is less than your 5 micron. So if your suspension has a particle size of 50 micron, that is known as a macro suspension. Right? Most of the suspension of pharmaceutical, they will have particle size range in the 1 to 50 micron. Particle size range iska kitna hota hai? 1 to 50 micron. It is a biphasic system. And remember, both suspension and emulsion, they are thermodynamically unstable. Wo stable nahi hote, unstable. So due to if you increase the temperature of suspension or if you increase the temperature of emulsion, okay, so there will be instability in the suspension and emulsion both. So because they are thermodynamically unstable. Okay, so you have to make them stable by addition of third component, that is suspending agent or emulsifying agent. So they act by in a different way. They decreases the suspending agent, mostly they increase the viscosity and decreases the attractive forces. Okay, decreases the rate of settling of particle. And in case of emulsion, emulsifying agent is there. So it decreases the surface and interfacial tension, okay, between oil molecule and water molecule. So first we will see the suspension. Remember, normally pharmaceutical suspension will have particle size in range of 1 to 50 micron. Whatever solid particle you are suspending, that will have particle size in range of 1 to 50 micron. Now aerosols again also consist of a suspension, okay, solid or liquid in gas. In case of aerosol also, there might be a two-phase system, three-phase system we have, but aerosol will not be discussed in this. We have only suspension. Again, system with the particle size smaller than 0.1 to 0.2 micron, generally considered as a colloidal solutions. So, agar koi solution mein पार्टिकल्स है वो सोल्यूबल नहीं है, लेकिन उनका साइज कितना है, 0.1 टू 0.2 माइक्रोन. सो ये ओके, ये पार्टिकल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द मीडियम व्हिच विल हैव अ साइज इन द रेंज ऑफ 0.1 टू 0.2 माइक्रोन. दे आर नोन एज अ कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन. दे आर नॉट अ ट्रू सॉल्यूशन, बट दे विल लुक लाइक अ ट्रू सॉल्यूशन. जैसे जो नॉर्मल सॉल्यूशन होता है उसमें क्या होता है कि जो भी आपका सॉल्यूट है वो डिसॉल्व होता है. कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन में क्या होता है कि वो सॉल्यूट डिसॉल्व नहीं होता है, लेकिन उसका पार्टिकल साइज इतना कम होता है कि आपको वो सॉल्यूशन जैसे दिखता है. सिस्टम विद पार्टिकल साइज स्मॉलर देन 0.1 टू 0.2 माइक्रोन जनरली कंसीडर्ड एज अ कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन, एंड दे एग्जिबिट प्रॉपर्टीज दैट लाई बिटवीन ट्रू मॉलिक्यूलर सॉल्यूशन एंड सस्पेंशन. तो ये जो कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन होता है तो इनका प्रॉपर्टी इन दोनों के बीच में होता है, क्योंकि ये ना सॉल्यूशन है ना सस्पेंशन है. तो प्रॉपरली उसको सस्पेंशन भी नहीं बोल सकते क्योंकि उसमें पार्टिकल साइज बहुत ही कम है और इट लुक लाइक अ सॉल्यूशन, और उसको सॉल्यूशन भी नहीं बोल सकते क्योंकि वो सॉल्यूट डिसॉल्व नहीं है. सो द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन लाइज बिटवीन दैट सस्पेंशन एंड सॉल्यूशन. नाउ टाइप्स ऑफ सस्पेंशन वी सी डिपेंडिंग ऑन द पार्टिकल साइज ऑफ सस्पेंडेड और डिपेंडिंग ऑन द पार्टिकल साइज ऑफ डिस्पर्स स्पेस. सो suspension are classified different way. Okay, so coarse suspension will have particle size. Okay, coarse suspension will have particle size more than 1 micron. More than 1 micron. Coarse suspension will have particle size. Particle size means dispersed phase particle size will be more than 1 micron. Colloidal dispersion will have particle size less than 1 micron. And nano suspension will have particle size in a range of 10 to 100 nanometer. So it is just an introduction slide. इसके ऊपर कभी कभी क्वेश्चन आ सकता है कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन का साइज, कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन जो होता है उसका पार्टिकल साइज नीचे होता है, ऑलरेडी आ चुका है 0.1 टू 0.2 माइक्रॉन. सो ये पार्टिकल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन अ साइज रेंज ऑफ 0.1 टू 0.2 माइक्रॉन, दे आर नोन एज अ कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन. एंड कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन दे आर नॉट अ ट्रू सॉल्यूशन, वो ट्रू सॉल्यूशन नहीं होते याद रखो. So colloidal solution, they are not a true solution, and that their properties lies between molecular dispersion, that means solution, molecular solution and suspension. And remember the types of suspension, their particle size. Okay, so coarse suspension will have particle size more than 1 micron. Colloidal dispersion will have particle size less than 1 micron, and nano suspension will have particle size in range of 10 to 100 nanometer. Remember, okay. Again, you see, suspension and emulsion, they are the biphasic liquid dosage form. They are the biphasic because two phases are involved. So one phase is a solid particle which is insoluble in the dispersion medium. So जो ज़्यादा quantity में होता है उसको बोलते हैं dispersion medium, और जो कम quantity में होता है उसको बोलते हैं dispersed medium. ठीक है, आपके easy language. So suppose that you want to prepare a paracetamol suspension. So whatever paracetamol powder or particles will be suspended in a simple syrup base. So simple syrup will be a continuous medium or a dispersion medium, and paracetamol particles will be dispersed phase. Okay. Suspension and emulsions are biphasic liquid dosage form. They are known for their property. They are known for their one important property, that is presence of boundary region between two phases. Okay. So these two dosage form will have two different phases. Okay, and in between these two phases, there exists a boundary layer. Okay, जैसे solid disperses in liquid, तो liquid और solid का जो point of contact है, वहाँ पे क्या होगा? Interface होगा. जैसे मान लीजिए कि if solids are suspended in the air, so at that time you will not call that interface, you will call them surface. Okay, so when solid is placed in the liquid, so there is a boundary of interface. Okay? There is an interface between solid and liquid. Again, liquid plus in liquid, again interface is there. These two dosage form thermodynamically unstable, and they has one important property that they will have a boundary region between these two phases. Okay. Now, insoluble solids, they will meet a liquid. Insoluble solid, they will meet a liquid at the interface. In case of suspension, so suspension में क्या है कि solid जो है, solid will meet at a liquid interface in suspension. But in case of emulsion, the interface is formed up between two immiscible liquids. So emulsion में क्या है? Two immiscible liquids होते हैं, जैसे oil and water. उनके बीच में जो interface है, उसकी वजह से वो interface वहाँ पे मिलते हैं. ठीक है? दूर से मिलते हैं interface तक. So interface will have positive free energy. Interface will have high positive free energy. Molecule at interface will have higher energy state than molecule which are located in the bulk of liquid. ठीक है, कुछ मॉलिक्यूल्स जो होंगे वो इसमें होंगे, इंटरफेस पे होंगे, जैसे सॉलिड और लिक्विड के दोनों का बीच का जो इंटरफेस है वहाँ पे होंगे, कुछ मॉलिक्यूल जो टोटली लिक्विड में होंगे. सो दोज मॉलिक्यूल विच आर प्रेजेंट और लोकेटेड एट द इंटरफेस दे विल हैव हाई पॉजिटिव एनर्जी. ओके, दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द हायर एनर्जी स्टेट देन मॉलिक्यूल लोकेटेड इन द बल्क ऑफ फेज. मॉलिक्यूल प्रेफर्स टू रिमेन इन द बल्क ऑफ लिक्विड as compared to interface, then it will have higher interfacial free energy. Remember this. Then again, effective formulation of your suspension involves the reduction in the positive free energy. So आपको करना क्या है कि आपको suspension बनाना है, तो क्या है आपको मालूम है कि क्या होता है कि those molecule which are present at the interface they will have higher positive free energy. So you have to decrease that to minimize the interaction, to minimize the repulsion. To minimize the repulsion. So effective formulation of suspension involves the reduction in the positive free energy near to zero. So effective formulation of suspension involves reduction in the positive free energy value to the zero by various approaches. So what are these various approaches? कैसे कर सकते हो आप? First, you can reduce the amount of interface. The interface, whatever amount of interface is, you can reduce that by doing the flocculation. Flocculation means aggregation of particles. So by doing the flocculation in the suspension, you can reduce the amount of interface available. And coalescence in case of emulsion. Coalescence of globules to form a one macrophase for emulsions. So that's how you can decrease the interfacial positive energy to stabilize. Suspension are nothing but the heterogeneous system with two phase. Liquid is known as a continuous phase and solid is known as a dispersed phase. So two phase system, liquid is known as a continuous phase or external phase, and solids are known as a dispersed phase or internal phase. Solids are dispersed, they are known as a internal phase or dispersed phase. Now if so that a solid particle is less than 1 nanometer, it is known as a molecular dispersion. अगर सॉलिड पार्टिकल का साइज 1 नैनोमीटर से कम है उसको बोलेंगे मॉलिक्यूलर डिस्पर्शन. क्वेश्चन आ चुका है. देन कोलाइडल डिस्पर्शन विल हैव पार्टिकल साइज इन द रेंज ऑफ 0.1 टू 0.2 माइक्रोन. ओके, देन कोर्स डिस्पर्शन विल हैव पार्टिकल साइज इन रेंज ऑफ मोर देन 0.2 माइक्रोन. पार्टिकल मोर देन 0.2 माइक्रोन है तो उसको बोलेंगे कोर्स डिस्पर्शन. पिछले साइड में मैंने 1 माइक्रोन बोला था क्योंकि वो अलग बुक से था. It is given in as a 1 micron in the CBS Subramanian. This is a point more than 0.2 micron is given in the LACMA. So this molecular dispersion, if particle size of dispersed particle is less than 1 nanometer, that is known as a molecular dispersion. Okay, that is a true solution. Molecular dispersion मतलब क्या है? True solution. इसको बोलेंगे true solution. Molecular dispersion means true solution. Then colloidal dispersion will have particle size in the range of 0.1 to 0.2 micron. कोर्स डिस्पर्शन विल हैव पार्टिकल साइज इन रेंज ऑफ मोर देन 2 माइक्रोन. थोड़ा सा याद रखो, क्वेश्चन इसके ऊपर कभी कभी आ जाता है. नाउ पार्टिकल्स इन द सस्पेंशन. सो पार्टिकल्स ऑफ डिस्पर्स फेज इन द सस्पेंशन मे रिमेन्स एज अ सिंगल एंटिटी और मे फॉर्म एग्लोमरेशन और लूज नेटवर्क. सो दे मे रिमेन एज अ डीप्लॉकुलेटेड. सो पार्टिकल्स इन द सस्पेंशन मे रिमेन एज अ डीप्लॉकुलेटेड और फ्लॉकुलेटेड. डीप्लॉकुलेटेड मीन्स क्या? सो पार्टिकल विल बिहेव इंडिविजुअली. डीप्लॉकुलेट मतलब हर एक के साथ किसी को कोई लेना देना नहीं, अपना अपना काम देखो. सो दैट इज अ डीप्लॉकुलेट. पार्टिकल बिहेव इंडिविजुअली इन द डीप्लॉकुलेट. इन केस ऑफ फ्लॉकुलेटेड सस्पेंशन सो देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एग्लोमरेशन. देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कलेक्शन ऑफ पार्टिकल्स. लूज, देर इज अ लूज पार्टिकल नेटवर्क इन केस ऑफ फ्लॉकुलेटेड सस्पेंशन. सो ये याद रखो, डीप्लॉकुलेट मतलब particle will behave single individually. Flocculate means particle will form a network. Okay, so that we are going to that flocculate, deflocculate, I will explain in the upcoming slides. Now there are different type of suspension. Okay, so first one is oral suspension. They are divided into different types. First one is oral suspension. Okay, so oral suspension consists of a high amount of solid like different kind of drugs like antibiotic preparation, antacid preparation, radiopaque suspension. Okay, so these drugs they are dispersed in the either syrup or sorbitol solution or any hydrocolloid plus water solution, okay, containing artificial sweeteners. They will act as a vehicle. They say syrup, simple syrup is 66.67% of sugar. That is known as a simple syrup, legally wrong. इसके ऊपर एक क्वेश्चन आ चुका है. What is simple syrup? 66.67% weight by volume. Solution of your sucrose is known as a simple syrup. Simple syrup IP मतलब क्या? Sucrose जो है आपका 66.67% weight by volume. That is known as a simple syrup. So that is a base. और sorbitol solution और जैसे होता है जैसे acacia gum और trichinal gum या फिर microcellular cellulose का solution. That is a solution thickened water containing artificial sweeteners will be vehicle for this, okay, oral suspension. Now if suspension consists of low, okay, if suspension is having low stability solids, अगर आपके suspension में जो solid आप डाल रहे हो उसका stability बहुत ही कम है. If your suspension, if your formulation has a very low stability, जैसे मान लीजिए 4-5 दिन के बाद वो खराब हो जाता है, तो उस time पे क्या करना है आपको? So don't make suspension right from the beginning. So what you have to do, you have to mix all the blends with additive in the powder form or granule form and dispense as it is in the granule form, and I'll provide along with that a sterile water, okay, for reconstitution. वो देखा होगा आपने कि कुछ कुछ बॉटल में क्या होता है कि वाटर अलग से मिलता है और बॉटल में पाउडर मिलता है, और आपको जब को यूज करना है आपको तब उसको खोल के आपको ये करना होगा, रिकंस्ट्रक्ट करना. सो रेडियोओपिक मीन्स व्हाट? सो रेडियोओपिक मीन्स फॉर द डायग्नोसिस. फॉर एग्जांपल योर फॉर डायग्नोसिस पर्पस यू आर यूजिंग वेरियस काइंड ऑफ सॉल्यूशन, कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन, ओके, और रेडियो कॉन्ट्रास्ट मीडिया फॉर डायग्नोसिस पर्पस, ओके. जैसे आपका होता है इनिमा, ओके, जैसे मिल्क ऑफ मैग्नीशिया इनिमा. सो आपको रेडियो टू विजुअलाइज द इंटरनल पार्ट ऑफ योर बॉडी, ठीक है, डायग्नोसिस के लिए. सो oral suspension. So oral suspension, if your suspension is not stable, then what you have to do, you have to just make a final mixture and or granules and put it back into bottle, okay, and provide along with it sterile water for reconstitution. So, the patient will reconstitute or patient will make the suspension he wants to use it. Now another kind of suspension may be oral suspension, topical suspension, intravenous parenteral suspension, etc. So second one is nothing but the parenteral suspension. Remember, in case of parenteral suspension, the solid content in a range of 0.5 to 5% weight by volume. So iske upar bhi question pucha hai, what is the solid content present in the parenteral suspension? So in case of parenteral suspension, solid content means dispersed phase will be around 0.5 to 5% weight by volume. But there is a exception, one exception is there. So penicillin suspension. So penicillin suspension may have a solid content up to 30%, okay. And remember, parenteral suspension will have low viscosity, they are commonly low viscosity and should be sterile, okay. So sterility usko hona chahiye. So parenteral suspension should be sterile, okay. Sterility should be ensured. So parenteral suspension should be sterile. They should have particle size range in a 0.5 to, sorry, they should have solid content in a range of 0.5 to 5%, okay. तो ज्यादा सॉलिड कंटेंट आप पेरेंटल सस्पेंशन में डाल नहीं सकते, अदरवाइज इट विल हार्म यू बिकॉज यू हैव टू इंट्रोड्यूस इनटू वेरियस योर. सो टाइम पे प्लीज टाइम टू टाइम टाइम जो दिया है उस पे आते जाओ, होता है कि थोड़ा सा मेरे को इजी होता है. सो रिमेंबर, पेरेंटल सस्पेंशन दे विल हैव अ सॉलिड कंटेंट इन रेंज ऑफ 0.5 to 5%, एक्सेप्ट इन पेनिसिलिन सस्पेंशन इट मे हैव अप टू 30%. They should be sterile, they will have low viscosity and commonly used vehicle for parenteral suspension. They should be isotonic, okay. So they should be isotonic with the blood plasma. Commonly used vehicle is nothing but the 0.9% sodium chloride, which is isotonic with the blood plasma, okay. And also again sometimes parenteral use vegetable oils. So जैसे RHS oil होता है, that is one of the oil which can be used parenterally. But if okay, suspension made from or injection made from oily vehicle, they are little bit painful. इसको थोड़ा सा pain हो जाएगा, ठीक. Then another kind of suspension, topical suspension. So there are a lot of topical suspension nowadays available. for a external application. So calamine lotion you might have seen, so it will have a high solid content up to more than 20%. So question aise bhi aa sakta hai aapko, one of the following type of suspension will have highest solid content. So topical suspension will have highest solid content, and topical suspension should have a dermatological acceptability, matlab dermatological testing matlab sab hona chahiye. So these are the mainly used suspension: oral suspension, topical suspension, parenteral suspension. Okay, the phenomena behind the formation of suspension. So there is a phenomena. Okay, what is the phenomena? Wetting. So wetting phenomena is the basis for your formation of suspension. We have seen this wetting phenomena in the detail. We have seen the DLVO theory in the detail. DLVO theory in the detail. When we was discussing about the colloid chapter, तो उसके बेसिस पे ये चैप्टर होता है. कोलाइड चैप्टर इसलिए मैंने माध्यम में बोला था आपको, प्लीज वॉच द कोलाइड चैप्टर वीडियो एंड सरफेस टेंशन इंटरवेंशन, बिकॉज दीज टू चैप्टर्स आर द बेस्ड अपॉन दोज टू चैप्टर्स फ्रॉम फिजिकल पर. सो व्हाट इज वेटिंग? वेटिंग मीन्स इंटीमेट कॉन्टेक्ट ऑफ यूर सॉलिड पार्टिकल एंड विद द मीडियम. ओके, सो सॉलिड्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन दैट, सॉलिड्स में भी आइदर हाइड्रोफिलिक. ओके, सॉलिड्स में भी आइदर हाइड्रोफिलिक और हाइड्रोफोबिक. सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय हाइड्रोफिलिक? What do you mean by hydrophilic? Solvent loving, or they are known as lyophilic. Solvent loving or lyophilic. So those solids which are hydrophilic or lyophilic, so they are easily wetted. So they are easily wetted. वो जल्दी ही भीग जाता है. मतलब आपको अपने देखो, आप वाटर में अगर कोई पार्टिकल डालोगे तो अगर वो भीगता ही नहीं तो फिर उसको कुछ नहीं कर सकते आप, सस्पेंशन नहीं बना सकते. So you cannot make a suspension of those particle which are not wetted by its medium. Medium may be either water or mixture of anything. So lyophilic or solvent loving or hydrophilic solids, they are easily wetted. Okay, and will increase the viscosity of water. When they will be wetted by water, so they will increase the viscosity of water. But on the other hand, hydrophobic or lyophobic or solvent hating solids, they are poorly wetted. They will have suspension with a suspension of hydrophobic solids, they will have very less viscosity and needs a wetting agent to make a suspension. So unko suspension banane ke liye aapko wetting agent use karna padega. Now contact angle is a indicator for wetting phenomenon. Kaun sa drug poorly wetted hai, kaun sa drug highly wet karta hai, kaun bolega aapko? So that is based upon the contact angle. We have seen details regarding the contact angle again in that same chapter. Some will have contact angle 0, some will have contact angle like 40. So if contact angle is less than 90, so that means that particles will be wetted. If contact angle is 0, that means that particle is fully wetted. Okay, if contact angle, okay, contact angle normally it is in a range of your 0 to 80, 180 degree. Contact angle kya kitna hota hai normally? Har ek particle ka alag hota hai, lekin normal range kya hai contact angle ka? So 0 to 180. So low contact angle between your solid and liquid will have good adhesive forces between solid and liquid, and that's why they cause good wetting or good wetting phenomenon or high wetting. In on the other hand, if there is a high contact angle, that means there is a poor wetting. So for this wetting phenomena, there is one equation known as a Young equation, which is the basis for wetting. Okay, तो यंग इक्वेशन होता है एक, दैट इज द बेसिस फॉर वेटिंग फिनोमेना. ठीक है, ये याद रखो. एंड इट इज बेस्ड अपॉन द चेंज इन द फ्री एनर्जी कॉस्ट बाय इंक्रीज इन द एरिया सॉलिड वेटेड बाय लिक्विड. अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस यंग्स इक्वेशन, इफ कॉन्टेक्ट एंगल बिटवीन सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड ओके इज लेस देन 90, सो दैट इंडिकेट देर इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग इंट्रैक्शन ऑफ सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड, देर इज अ वेटिंग, प्रॉपर वेटिंग और वेटिंग ऑकर्स. अगर कॉन्टैक्ट एंगल सॉलिड का और लिक्विड का अगर 90 डिग्री से कम है, उसका मतलब ये होता है कि वो सॉलिड जो है वो अच्छे से वेट हो रहा है. इफ इट इज मोर देन 90 डिग्री, दैट मीन्स योर सॉलिड इज नॉट प्रॉपरली वेटेड बाय लिक्विड. सो ये स्टर्न डिफ्यूज लेयर डीबी लेंथ क्या होता है वो नेक्स्ट स्लाइड में मैं बोलूंगा. वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन द कोलाइड चैप्टर पार्टिकल पार्टिकल इंट्रैक्शन, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट अट्रैक्टिव फोर्सेस, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट रिपल्सिव फोर्सेस. ओके, व्हाट इज प्राइमरी मिनिमम, व्हाट इज प्राइमरी secondary minimum, what is the primary minimum, what is the primary maximum, what is the secondary minimum. So we have seen in the DLVO theory. So same theory is also applicable for this, but I'm not going to repeat it. Remember lyophobic material in the suspension. Okay, lyophobic material in the suspension. If suspension is made up of a lyophobic material and if you add electrolyte or salt, what will happen? So there will be they are nothing but the lyophilic material in suspension. They are sensitive for the electrolytes. That means if you add an electrolyte where there is a lyophobic material suspension, so it will cause precipitation or उसका caking हो जाएगा. मतलब लायोफोबिक मटेरियल का सस्पेंशन अगर है उसमें अगर आपने सॉल्ट वगैरह डाल दिया उसमें क्या होगा, एक तो लायोफोबिक मतलब पोअरली वेटेड होता है, वो पोअरली वेट होता है, पहले ही कम वेट होता है वो, और उसके ऊपर भी आपने इलेक्ट्रोलाइट डाल दिया. इलेक्ट्रोलाइट एडिशन मीन्स व्हाट? इलेक्ट्रोलाइट विल हैव चार्ज ऑन देयर आयंस. ओके, सो देयर विल बी मोर रिपल्शन अट्रैक्शन एक्सेट्रा, रिपल्सिव फोर्सेस विल बी डोमिनेटेड. सो देयर विल बी separation of two pieces, there will be formation of cake. So breaking of your lyophilic material in suspension, they are sensitive for the electrolyte, but lyophilic are not sensitive. But if you add large quantity of electrolyte in lyophilic suspension also, so they are going to precipitate. Normally lyophobic material ka suspension jo hai wo sensitive hota hai for the electrolyte addition, lyophilic nahi hota hai. बट अगर क्वांटिटी ज्यादा है तो लायोफिलिक सस्पेंशन कभी क्या होगा, बाद में प्रेसिपिटेशन हो सकता है. नाउ यू कैन सी ओवर हियर, सो सपोज दैट दिस इज योर सॉलिड पार्टिकल, ये जो है सॉलिड पार्टिकल है, सॉलिड पार्टिकल के ऊपर पॉजिटिव चार्ज, सो अगेंस्ट दैट पॉजिटिव चार्ज नेगेटिव चार्ज विल बी अट्रैक्टेड. ओके, नेगेटिव चार्ज विल बी अट्रैक्टेड. सो इन द वेरी फर्स्ट लेयर देयर विल बी ओनली नेगेटिव चार्ज. ओके, इट इज नोन एज अ स्टर्न लेयर. ओके, so it is known as a stern layer. Okay, this is known as a stern layer. And after that, to balance that negative charge, some positive charge and negative charge will be there. So this is known as a positive, this is known as a diffuse layer or second layer. Okay, so ye apne physical performance mein dekha hai what is primary layer, secondary diffuse layer, etc. Primary layer here is known as a stern layer, secondary layer is a diffuse layer, and after that there is a bulk of solution. Now you can see over here. Now this stern layer is there. So whatever the length of this stern layer, so that can be diffused. वो पूरा के पूरा ऐसे diffuse मतलब जाता है. And after that there is a diffuse layer. So you can see in this stern layer, then diffuse layer and debye length. Debye length is nothing but the debye length is nothing but the 1/k. So length of your stern layer which can be moved, which can be moved. So length of your stern layer which can be moved known as a debye length. There is 1/k. So actually it is a part of DLBO theory. We have already seen. I'm not going to repeat. यहाँ पे DLBO theory का कुछ ऐसा ये रहता है. So you can see over here. So if you plot a attractive repulsive forces and the distance between two particles, distance between two particles on x-axis, attractive and repulsive forces. So you will get some assumptions. So we have seen in the DLBO theory. At a primary minimum, so there is a more attraction of particle. So at the primary minimum is what? So there is a very less distance between two particles. So what will happen? Attractive forces will dominate it and they will cause agglomeration and cake formation in the primary minimum. So attractive forces. So this attractive forces are countered by this repulsive forces known as a primary maximum. And secondary, this secondary minimum indicate the force for propulsion. कि इस सेकेंडरी मिनिमम क्या इंडिकेट करता है कि फोर्स जो फोर्स रिक्वायर्ड टू लूज अट्रैक्टिव फोर्स बिटवीन टू मॉलिक्यूल टू फॉर्म ए लूज एग्रीगेट और फ्लॉकुल्स. ओके, दैट इज दैट विल इंडिकेटेड बाय सेकेंडरी मिनिमम विल इंडिकेट द फोर्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर फ्लॉकुलेशन एंड द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन सेकेंडरी मिनिमम एंड प्राइमरी मिनिमम दैट विल डिसाइड वेदर द पार्टिकल्स इन द सस्पेंशन विल रिमेन इन द फ्लॉकुलेटेड फॉर्म और डीफ्लॉकुलेट. So this distance, primary maximum and secondary minimum. But remember कि जो यहाँ पे जो primary minimum होता है, so at the primary minimum there is a attractive forces are dominated and there will causes it causes the precipitation or accumulation of particles. Strong accumulation. यहाँ पे भी accumulation होता है, लेकिन यहाँ पे loose aggregate form. So there is a formation of loose aggregate at this secondary minimum, which is known as a फोर्स ऑफ प्रॉपुलेशन. तो सेकेंडरी मिनिमम का जहाँ पे जो ये होगा, जहाँ पे जो द फोर्स बिटवीन टू मॉलिक्यूल्स, सो अट्रैक्टिव फोर्स बिटवीन टू मॉलिक्यूल्स, सो इलेक्ट्रोकाइनेटिक that is known as a force of flocculation. So flocculation will be there in case of secondary medium. Flocculation means loose aggregate formation. Aggregate formation is so loose or tight nahi. Tight agar hoga to wo caking hoga. Caking is a instability. Okay, this flocculation is not an instability. And the distance between these two, primary minimum, primary maximum, and secondary minimum, will decide whether your suspended particle will remain in the flocculated form or deflocculated. Types of suspension we have already seen. Once again, see oral suspension in which solid particle or drug is dispersed in the medium, which is already which will have either sweetening agent or flavoring agent or coloring agent. Okay, and remember, oral suspension, they are expressed as a API per 5 ml. Okay, आपने देखा होगा, each 5 ml of paracetamol suspension, IP custom paracetamol 250 ml. आपने देखा होगा. Okay, that means it is expressed in the form of API per 5 ml. Then different kind of oral suspension are there, as we have seen in the first line, antibiotics, analgesic, and other drugs like antacids, radiopaque substance. Antacids and radiopaque suspension, they will usually will have higher solid content than other. In topical suspension or topical element like calamine lotion and all that, topical application, dermatology and cosmetic purpose. Parenteral suspension, so total solid content, that is 0.5 to 1% normally, but it is 30% in case of your penicillin suspension mein 30% ho sakta hai. Normally kitna hota hai? 0.5 to 1%. And parenteral suspension are designed for either intramuscular, subcutaneous, or different kind of injection, intra-arterial injection or intravenous injection, etc. They are not terminally sterilized but prepared aseptically. Aerosols we have already seen. Liposome and micro suspension of liposomes, microsphere, microcapsule, monosphere, nanosphere, nanocapsules, they are under control. Powder for suspension. So I have already told you, if your suspension is not stable, then you have to dispense that suspension in the form of powder or granules along with the medium or water or sterile water. When patient will purchase that, it will reconstruct. You will reconstruct at the time of dose to avoid the stability problem. Now suspending agent, different kind of suspending agent. What will they do? They will increase the viscosity of your medium. Yeah, the viscosity increase karega. These are the compound used to keep particles of drug in the suspended state or suspended form in the continuous space. It is also known as a thickening agent. Suspending agent, they are also known as a thickening agent, and usually they are nothing but the hydrocolloids. Okay, hydrophilic colloids. Different gums jo hai aapke wo hote. So when acacia, tragacanth, cellulose, they will be dissolved in the water. So what will happen? They will increase the viscosity of water and they will prevent the rate of settling of particles, okay? Which is governed by Stokes' law. So here classes, example, ionic charge is given and concentration in which they are used. So first one is the cellulose derivative like methyl cellulose, HP, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, sodium CMC, sodium carboxymethyl cellulose. So out of that, methyl cellulose and HPMC, both these are the neutral. Sodium CMC is anionic, okay? So it will have negative charge. They are used in the concentration like this, 1 to 5%, 0.32%, 0.5 to 2%, okay? So methyl cellulose used in the as a suspending agent in this concentration. Hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose is used as a 0.3 to 2%. Then sodium CMC is used in a concentration of 0.5 to 2%. So concentration yaad nahi rakha to bhi chalega, koi dikkat nahi. Sirf itna yaad rakho ki uske upar charge kaun sa hota hai. Then next is a polymers like carbomer and povidone. So carbomer is anionic in nature and povidone is a neutral. Then gums, different gums, or it is known as a hydrophilic hydrocolloids. So xanthan gum is there, so it is anionic in nature. Then carrageenan is there. Okay, carrageenan is anionic in nature. Acacia, tragacanth, they are again anionic in nature. Sodium alginate, it is again anionic in nature. So inorganic suspending agent, for example, bentonite, hectorite, and aluminium magnesium silicate. So remember, these inorganic, they are used for external preparation. ये एक्सटर्नल प्रिपरेशन के लिए समटाइम्स टू इंक्रीज द वेटिंग फिनोमेनन इफ योर सॉलिड इज हाइड्रोफोबिक इन नेचर और इफ सॉलिड इज लायोफोबिक इन नेचर इन दैट केस टू इंक्रीज द वेटिंग वी हैव टू यूज आइदर सरफेस एक्टिव एजेंट और वेटिंग एजेंट सो नॉर्मली पॉलीसॉर्बेट 80 दैट इज मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज मोस्ट वाइडली यूज पॉलीसॉर्बेट 20 इज ऑल्सो यूज सोडियम लॉरिल सल्फेट is used for external so they are non ionic what is theoretical consideration for this so wetting phenomenon is very important DLEW theory and wetting phenomenon is the basis for suspension we have already seen this wetting phenomenon in the detail we have seen the DLEW theory in detail so please go on so wetting of poorly wettable solids jo poorly wettable hai पोअरली वेटेड होता है सो मोस्टली पोअरली वेटेड कौन होता है हाइड्रोफोबिक सॉलिड्स सो वेटिंग एजेंट आर यूज्ड टू इंक्रीज द वेटिंग ऑफ पोअरली वेटेड सब्सटेंसेस और पोअरली वेटेड सॉल्ट दैट इज हाइड्रोफोबिक सॉल्ट और लायोफोबिक सॉल्ट लायोफोबिक मतलब सॉल्वेंट हीटिंग हाइड्रोफोबिक मतलब वाटर हीटिंग सो वेटिंग एजेंट आर यूज्ड अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्वेंट रिक्वायर्ड टू वेट द होल पाउडर इज द वेट पॉइंट सो अमाउंट ऑफ amount of solvent, whatever any solvent required to weight the whole powder is known as a wet point. And wet point is expressed as a liter per 100 gram. ये क्या था बोले liter per 100 gram. Okay. Now normal wet point values are they are in between 15 to 45. Lower is the wet point value, better will be the wetting agent. इसका wet point value कम है, वो wetting agent ज़्यादा है, ज़्यादा अच्छा है. Okay. फिर से एक बार यहाँ पे यहाँ पे एक शॉर्ट शॉर्ट पॉइंट ही दे रहा हूँ सो वी आर नॉट डीलिंग द चैप्टर इन द वेरी मच डिटेल वेटिंग ऑफ पुअरली वेटेबल सॉलिड्स ओके सो रिमेंबर व्हाट इज वेटिंग पॉइंट द अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्वेंट रिक्वायर्ड टू वेट होल पाउडर इज नोन एज अ वेटिंग पॉइंट वेट पॉइंट एंड इट इज एक्सप्रेस्ड एज अ लीटर पर 100 ग्राम इट विल हैव वैल्यू इन रेंज ऑफ 15 टू 45 सो इफ द वेटिंग पॉइंट इज लेस विल बी द वेटिंग पॉइंट of your wetting point of your wetting agent more better will be the wetting agent so wetting agent ka agar wetting point kam hai to wo acha wetting agent then particle interaction actually it is a part of DLEW theory again so remember few points over here so lyophobic material in suspension they are sensitive for the small addition of salt and when you add a small addition small amount of salt it will cause precipitation or caking and lyophilic material are not sensitive but if you add high quantity of then again lyophilic will also be present lyophilic material such as a gum is readily wet by water if large amount of electrolytes are added may affect the solution or may change the phase of solution by salting out a bit lyophobic material on dilution reverses the precipitation of lyophilic solid lyophobic material hai usko agar zyada dilute karenge तो जो प्रेसिपिटेशन हुआ है वो रिवर्स हो जाएगा स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ हाइड्रोफोबिक कोलाइड इज आल्सो रिड्यूस्ड बाय लोअरिंग द रिपल्सिव पोटेंशियल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल डबल लेयर बाय डिक्रीजिंग द डिग्री ऑफ हाइड्रेशन एक्चुअली इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ DLEW थ्योरी इसलिए मैंने बोला था ऊपर क्या एंड ऑप्टिमम कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट नीडेड टू इफेक्ट द ऑप्टिमल एग्रीगेशन डिपेंड्स ऑन द बैलेंस एंड टाइप ऑफ इंटरेक्टिंग आयन एंड इट इज गिवन बाय Schultz-Hartley rule. इसका रूल भी पूरा अपन ने देखा है कोलाइड्स में पूरा डिटेल में देखा है नाउ यू कैन सी here is one table contact angle of few pharmaceutical drugs used in the suspension for example potassium chloride will have contact angle of 21 potassium then sodium chloride 28 lactose 30 then caffeine 43 paracetamol 59 so you can see more will be the contact angle more will be the contact angle less will be the wetting you can see over here chloramphenicol palmitate iska contact angle kitna hai 121 so it will be poorly wetted chloramphenicol palmitate baki a potassium chloride dekho contact angle ke 21 to ye easily dissolve ho jayega water lactose caffeine like so no need to remember all this so just for your understanding purpose so chloramphenicol simple chloramphenicol will have angle of contact angle 59 phenobarbital will have contact angle 70 sulfadiazin 71 aspirin 75 phenacetin 78 okay polyethylene that will have 100, salicylic acid will have 103, magnesium stearate 121. So you can see as the contact angle increases, the weighting will be decreased. तो यहाँ पे वेटिंग क्या होगा, इधर कम हो जाएगा. क्वांटम एंगल जितना ज्यादा उतना वेटिंग कम, क्वांटम एंगल जितना कम उतना वेटिंग ज्यादा. सो डिक्रीजिंग द वेटिंग, यू कैन सी क्वांटम एंगल. सो यहाँ पे देखो, इफ क्वांटम एंगल इज जीरो दैट मीन्स इट इज अ फुल्ली वेटेड. क्वांटम एंगल अगर जीरो है तो सॉलिड क्या है, फुल्ली वेटेड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू प्लेस अ ड्रॉप ऑफ वाटर ऑन ड्रॉप ऑफ वाटर, इट इज अ फुल्ली वेटेड मीन्स क्वांटम एंगल जीरो. If contact angle is less than 90, if contact angle is less than 90, again solid can be weighted. If contact angle is more than 90, so it is not easy to weight the solid. And if contact angle is 180, then it is not poorly weighted. You cannot cause weighting of that. We have to use weighting agents. The formation of the particle A, aapka particle size in the range of 1 to 10 micron. So you have to disperse, you have to increase the weighting of that particular disperse in a dispersing medium. There will be formation of suspension. If you want to make a flocculus, you can make flocculation. Stable flocculation, okay? This is known as flocculation. If you want to again the breakdown of these flocculus, that process is known as a peptidization. Peptidization of deep peptidization or deep flocculation. So formation of flocculus known as a flocculation, and breakdown of flocculus known as a peptidization or deflocculation. Okay, so at this time yahan tak aapka suspension stable hai. So once there is a agglomeration or coagulation, suspension is not stable, suspension will be separated, suspension will separate ho jayega. And again, so if there is a crystal growth, again suspension is unstable, suspension is stable up to this point. Okay, what is flocculating agent? So flocculating agent, these are the again flocculating agent. So they will decrease the zeta potential near to zero, as it is question asked by GPT. What will the flocculating agent do? They will decrease the zeta potential near to zero of the of the suspending charged particle, and causes the aggregation of flocculi formation. So that is a flocculating agent. Flocculating agent will enhance the stability of suspension by decreasing the zeta potential to zero. Zeta potential kya hota hai, we have seen the colloid chapter. Electrolytes like sodium chloride, potassium chloride, sulfate, citrate, phosphate, salt, they are used as a flocculating agent. Flocculation also result because of the decreasing the solubility of polymer in the tino b sentences. Bahut hi zyada important hai, question iske upar aata hai. So remember, flocculating agent will decrease the zeta potential near to zero. Electrolyte like sodium chloride, potassium chloride, sulfate, citrate, potassium salt, they are also used as a flocculating agent. Okay, flocculation can result from the decreasing the solubility in the polymer. Then next phenomenon is Ostwald ripening. Iske upar question aa chuka hai. Ostwald ripening is related with one of the following dosage form. To suspension, emulsion, tablet, capsule. So it is related with the suspension. Ostwald ripening. So because of the suspension, because suspensions are nothing but the saturated solution of particle, small change in the temperature that occurs during the shelf life or storage condition leads to unexpected rapid caking and crystal bridging, as a crystal growth. This phenomenon is known as the Ostwald ripening, and it is unavoidable. देखो यहाँ पे suspension अगर आपने बहुत time पे store किया और वहाँ का temperature थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा है, temperature affect the stability of suspension emulsion bond. Temperature क्या करेगा, accelerate कर देगा क्या, crystal growth. Okay, so as the suspension is nothing but the, it is a saturated solution, suspension is nothing but the saturated with the solid content in the dispersion medium. So little change in the temperature that occurs during the shelf life or storage of that causes unexpectedly rapid caking and crystal bridging. Rapid caking via crystal bridging, and this phenomenon is known as a Ostwald ripening. So aisa bhi question puchte hai yahan pe. One of the following is not a instability in case of suspension. So, वहाँ पे लेंगे cracking, deflocculation, Ostwald ripening, creaming. So देखो crack मतलब यहाँ पे लेंगे, वहाँ पे लेंगे precipitation. एक रहेगा precipitation. One of the following is not a instability of suspension. First option precipitation, second option रहेगा आपका deflocculation, third option रहेगा वो स्वेल रैपनिंग, फोर्थ ऑप्शन रहेगा क्रीमिंग। क्रीमिंग इज अ इंस्टेबिलिटी ऑफ योर इमल्शन, यहाँ पे ऐसा क्वेश्चन आ सकता है। और सेडिमेंटेशन रेट, तो सेडिमेंटेशन रेट मीन्स द रेट ऑफ सेटलिंग ऑफ पार्टिकल, ठीक है, आपका सस्पेंशन में क्या है, पार्टिकल सस्पेंडेड फॉर्म में, सो रेट ऑफ सेटलिंग ऑफ पार्टिकल इज गिवन बाय स्टोक्स लॉ, उसका एक इक्वेशन दिया है वो आप देख लो। स्टोक्स लॉ इज एप्लीकेबल एंड डिस्क्राइब द सेडिमेंटेशन वेलोसिटी ऑफ पार्टिकल इन सस्पेंशन, सो रेट ऑफ सेटलिंग ऑफ पार्टिकल इज गिवन बाय स्टोक्स लॉ। सस्पेंशन हैविंग सॉलिड लेस देन 2 ग्राम्स ऑफ सॉलिड पर 100 ml ओनली फॉलोज द स्टोक्स लॉ, तो उस जो सस्पेंशन में 2 ग्राम सॉलिड है 100 ml में और उससे कम है तभी आप स्टोक्स लॉ अप्लाई कर सकते हो। इफ देयर इज अ हायर सॉलिड कंटेंट देन 2 ग्राम पर 100 ml देन स्टोक्स लॉ इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल। नेगेटिव वेलोसिटी मे रिजल्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द टू डिफरेंस इन द टू डेंसिटी, सच रिजल्ट इन टू फ्लोटिंग और क्रीमिंग। सो यहाँ पे देखो, अगर डिस्पर्स पार्टिकल्स जो है उसका डेंसिटी ज्यादा है तो सेटल कहाँ पे होगा, नीचे होगा, वाटर मीडियम से ज्यादा है तो नीचे होगा, अगर मीडियम से कम है उसका डेंसिटी तो ऊपर होगा, लेकिन मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम नीचे ही होता है क्योंकि यहाँ पे सॉलिड पार्टिकल्स है। केकिंग, केकिंग फिनोमेना फॉर्मेशन ऑफ नॉन रीडिस्पर्सिबल सेडिमेंट विद इन अ सस्पेंशन, देयर इज अ मेजर कॉज ऑफ केकिंग इज नथिंग बट द क्रिस्टल ब्रिजिंग एंड क्लोज एग्रीगेट फॉर्मेशन। केकिंग क्या है आपका, इट इज नथिंग बट द केकिंग प्रेसिपिटेशन, केकिंग प्रेसिपिटेशन, ओस्वाल्ड रैपनिंग, these are the instability problems, okay, these are the instability problems of your suspension. See difference between flocculators, deflocculated suspension. Flocculators, flocculated suspension mein kya hota hai, so particles will form a loose aggregate and they will look like a network, they will form a network like structure, they will, okay, so they will not easily settle, they will form a loose network so in flocculators, and sedimentation is rapid and high sedimentation rate is there in case of flocculator suspension. But though there is a high sedimentation rate and they are sedimented rapidly, so you can easily redisperse them. Loosely packed sediment not forms a hard cake. They can be easily redispersed. It's not a pleasant. ठीक है, तो flocculator में क्या होता है कि जो particle है एक में के साथ में loosely एक loose bond में flocculus बनते हैं, मतलब aggregate बनते हैं, दो वो जल्दी सेटल हो जाते हैं, लेकिन शेक किया तो फिर से रीडिस्पर्स हो जाते हैं, बट हियर सस्पेंशन विल नॉट हैव अ प्लीजेंट लुक, फ्लॉकल्स विल टेंड टू स्टिक द साइड ऑफ बॉटल, बॉटल के साइड में वो चिपक जाते हैं। नाउ डीफ्लॉकुलेटेड सस्पेंशन पार्टिकल एग्जिस्ट एज अ सेपरेट एंटिटी, डू नॉट फॉर्म एग्रीगेट, तो डीफ्लॉकुलेटेड सस्पेंशन में जो पार्टिकल सस्पेंडेड है वो हर एक पार्टिकल अलग अलग है, सो दे आर इंडिविजुअल। सेडिमेंटेशन रेट इज वेरी स्लो, okay, sedimentation is slow, but once there is sedimentation, so it will form a hard cake and they are not easy to redisperse. Ek bar cake ban gaya to wo, and it will have a pleasant appearance, but and they will not stick to side of bottle. To ye difference bhi ek yaad rakho, kabhi kabhi iske upar question aata. Now evaluation of suspension stability, suspension ka stability aap kaise evaluate karoge, so sedimentation volume, for ideal suspension sedimentation volume should be 0, but it is not possible, so it is less than 1. Question aa chuka hai, what is the sedimentation volume for ideal suspension? So it should be 0, it should be 0, but it is not possible, so it is less than 1. So sedimentation volume for ideal suspension is less than 1. Question as it is aa chuka hai. Then electrokinetic techniques like measurement of zeta potential links attacks, particle size changes, so using it is done, it is analyzed by using Bridge thaw, rheological study like viscosity by using Brookfield viscometer. So these are the evaluation of suspension stability, the points important. So this was regarding suspension, and we will see now.